I didn't mean to do that. Thank you for using Detroit buses.
All right. End of the line.
End of the line?
Yeah, you're gonna have to leave.
Wake up. We have to go. Do you know if there's any other place we could spend the night?
I have no idea. She's gonna have to leave.
That's not ideal.
Okay. We'll find somewhere to spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry. A motel. Looks like we found a place to stay.
We're not going in?
We have to find $40 and get rid of this uniform. Or go somewhere else.
See, I don't trust trying to cross the street without it being green, because after all the other stupid things I've done that have gotten my other characters killed.
It's warm in here. You'll feel better in no time. Come on, let's go.
Where are you going? Please don't let me get hit by a car.
Alice, you're freezing cold.
I'm okay. I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight. Look, the store is still open. Maybe we should go inside. At least you'll be out of the cold.
What do you want?
I'm with a little girl, and we have nowhere to go. Could you spare some money so we can get a room for tonight?
Shit. A homeless android? Ah, that's the best yet. Look, this is a convenience store. Not the Salvation Army, okay? You better go if you're not gonna buy anything.
An abandoned house. At least we'd be out of the rain.
Kara, I don't like this place.
I know. But it's just for one night, and no one will look for us here.
You can cut the fence here with a wire cutter. What wire cutter?
There's nothing more this way.
Mm.
Come on, let's go back.
Ugh. Am I gonna be forced to have to shoplift or rob the place or something? Yeah, but there's nowhere to get wire cutters, you goofy thing. Oh, found some wire cutters.
Are you all right?
Yes, it's just a scratch. Be careful. Don't worry, we're just having a look. Alice? Alice! Wait, what are you doing?
Visitors. Ralph doesn't like visitors. They're nasty. They may hurt Ralph.
I don't know what the humans did to you, but she had nothing to do with it.
All humans want to hurt us. But Ralph won't let them hurt him again. No, he won't let them.
She's just a little girl. She's not gonna hurt you.
Little girl? She's not a little girl. Anyway, what does that matter? Maybe she wants to hurt Ralph.
We thought nobody was here. All we want is a place to spend the night.
Visitors are dangerous. Look. They did to Ralph.
Poor guy.
You have nothing to worry about. We're not going to do you any harm. You have my word.
You must excuse Ralph. Perhaps he'll find it difficult to control himself. Sometimes his fear makes him do things he regrets. Ralph has seen some hard times. He's just so scared the humans will get him again. You can stay if you want. Ralph won't hurt you.
Okay. We'll just stay the night.
Come on! Come. Come, come on.
I've made a bad decision again, haven't I?
Ralph has lived here since he ran away. Ralph never goes outside, so no one knows he lives here. Humans come in to squat from time to time, but, you know, Ralph just hides till he leaves. You can make yourself at home here. Ralph is gonna go into the other room. He would like to stay with you. But he has things to do.
It's just for one night, Alice. We'll find a better place tomorrow. Right. Let's see where you can sleep. Sit down and I'll start a fire.
If I start a fire, is he gonna flip?
You can come to bed. I did what I could. It's not much, but at least you'll be warm.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Can we just be happy?
I don't know, Alice.
You'll never leave me, right? Promise you'll never go.
I promise.
Will we be together forever?
Forever.
Thank you.
asleep. What does that mean?
What?
Those symbols. Why are you writing that?
I don't know. I don't know.
Find Jellicoe! Find Jellicoe!
That's creepy. Also, was that body he pushed out of the way earlier, Connors? Or was that just something my imagination?
I'm an AK-700 android. I was designed to serve you. What can I do for you? Hello. I'm an AK-700 android.
My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact me near the satellite mission.
Evening, how are you? dang crazy scene. Why? So, wait, if he's alive, does that mean Connor's gonna be alive later, or? This stuff, or different stuff? Someone else, though. Somebody's in a bit of a mood. Was he whole again without any problems? What an interesting sidewalk. I would fall over and break my scrawny little neck.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor.
She's pretty.
It's good to see you.
What a cutie. Not him.
Your predecessor was unfortunately destroyed. It knew deviants could be unpredictable, but it wasn't careful enough. I hope you won't make the same mistake.
I don't intend to.
When a Connor model is destroyed, its memory is transferred to the next one. But some data can be lost in the process. Avoid being destroyed. It will be better for you and the investigation.
I understand.
The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It could have killed everyone in the room. The previous Connor should have anticipated the danger. It was a mistake to let an armed policeman so close to the deviant.
this Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the Deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I would define him as dysfunctional. He obviously has a personal situation impacting his professional behavior and seems to have no interest in the investigation.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will adapt to his personality. It is in the best interest of the investigation that I avoid conflict and try to accommodate his psychology.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Pick up the investigation where the previous Connor left off and put a stop to this. Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Okay, the music associated with her does not make me think she's a good lady.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Oh, shit. That fucking machine can kill everyone in the room.
You and you
excuse me. Found it.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Hello, Lieutenant. My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
God, I saw you get shot in the head last night.
My predecessor was unfortunately destroyed, but CyberLife transferred its memory and sent me to replace it. This incident should not affect the investigation.
Oh, Jesus. Hank! In my office!
So I could explore the office, or I could listen. Let's listen.
I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Sounds like my mom, actually. Bullshit!
The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you let me hold the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick!
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off! You are a police lieutenant! You are supposed to do what I say! Pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel. This conversation is over.
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitch. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do.
I get the impression my presence causes you some inconvenience, Lieutenant. I'd like you to know I'm very sorry about that. In any case, I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you. I'm sure we'll make a great team. Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better.
Heavens above, he's trying so hard.
Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo.
Take a look at these samples yet?
I call him Sumo.
Maybe I'll try that MD4 with red ice.
You're a Detroit Gears fan, right? Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
Oh.
Oops.
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such. But I'd like to. A lot of people don't appreciate having androids around. I was wondering, is there any reason in particular you despise me?
Yeah. There is one.
Dang it.
I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
Oh no, I shouldn't.
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
Dang it.
Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah, too long.
If you have any files on Deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Poor kid. Deuce is trying to do his job.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have assaulted a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation.
Right. Take a look at these samples.
I understand you're facing personal issues, Lieutenant.
Oh no, I probably shouldn't have picked that
but
either.
You need to move past them, and...
Hey! Don't talk to me like you know me. I'm not your friend, and I don't need your advice, okay?
Oops.
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Dang.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. But things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant, sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that attacked the guy last night. It's been seen in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
Oops. Oops. Okay then, all right. Anyway, back to the point here. Supposed to do while I wait, just like sit or what else could I look at? No clothes in here.
That's all for now. Free to go.
We've got officers sweeping the neighborhood in case anybody saw anything.
Okay, well, let me know if they turn anything up.
What are you gonna do with that?
I have no idea.
It took the first bus that came along and stayed at the end of the line. Its decision wasn't planned. It was driven by fear.
Androids don't feel fear.
Deviants do. They get overwhelmed by their emotions and make irrational decisions.
All right, well, that still doesn't tell us where it went.
It didn't have a plan, and it had nowhere to go. Maybe it didn't go far.
Maybe.
Uh-oh.
Ralph found this to feed the little girl. It's good for her. A present. To make up for past misunderstandings. Ralph will cook. We will do just like humans do. Humans like burnt meat. Come. Come and sit down.
That's very kind of you, Ralph. But we have to go.
Go? No, you will go once the little girl is eaten. We will eat together, just like a family. You know, the father, the mother, and the little girl. That's better.
Oh, he
Ralph
keeps me out.
Went to a lot of trouble to find something for the little girl to eat. It wouldn't be polite for her to refuse, would it? Succulent, you'll see. Succulent. Succulent. Father, mother, little girl.
Please, Kara. I don't want to keep that.
What did she say?
She said she doesn't want to eat it.
But I should have done it.
Well, maybe it's not good enough. Maybe she's used to better things. But Ralph did this for her, so she's going to eat! Go ahead. Eat.
Please don't. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it.
We're going to stand up now, and we're going to leave, Ralph.
No. No, you're not going to leave. Not until Ralph says so.
You said you wanted to be like a family, Ralph. Father, mother, the little girl, remember? Father would never threaten his little girl with a knife to make her eat.
Ralph led to a lot of trouble. That's why. He just wanted the little girl to eat.
This is creepy.
But Ralph is not bad. No. Not bad.
Then let us go.
Anybody home? There's blue blood on the fence. I know another android was here.
Thank you.
I'm looking for an AX-400. Have you seen it?
Ralph's seen nobody.
Don't be afraid. I'm not gonna hurt you. Are there any other androids here?
Other androids? No. Ralph is alone.
There's blue blood on the fence. I know another android was here.
Ralph scratched himself coming through. That's Ralph's blood.
Coming, Lieutenant! Is anyone upstairs?
No. Nobody.
I don't know what else to do but, like, come back over here and look at the thing. To do. upstairs anyway. It's like nothing else for me to be able to do. I can't go up the stairs. Dang it, come on.
Connor, the fuck are you doing? Did you find something?
No. No, it's not here.
Yeah, just like I said in the first place. Come on, let's get out of here.
Wait, where'd the guy go? Wait, where'd he go? This is so weird. What just happened? Okay.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have
existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
Symbol am I supposed to, oh, that one. I was like, what symbol am I supposed to be looking for?
Sure, I'll talk to you later.
sit in real quick. Okay. So what graffiti symbol am I supposed to be looking at again?
Sorry. Excuse me.
I think he just pickpocketed me. Tried to, but he's really... Robots and events. Wasn't there, like, something over here that I use? Okay, buddy. Go, get through. Yeah, I'm back in. Can I go back up? I can't go back out. Oh, that's not ideal. Ah. The third one. So where is this thing? Cannot believe I didn't see that there. Like, well, here we go. Okay then. What was I looking for again? I'm back, sorry. Okay. Oh, there it is. I didn't even see that one there. Okay, then. Well, there isn't another way across, because of course there isn't. That would be too easy. Upside, he doesn't feel like catching tetanus. Thank you. No. What the heck was that? That just scared the crap out of me. What was that? Please don't scare the poo out of me again. I really don't want jump scares. I hate jump scares. Nuggets, hello.
Welcome to Jericho.
What was that thing running around then? Because that scared the poo out of me.